Welcome to the Mischief. I'm Velen, and this is Botany Pots, similar to Bonsai Pots, but expansive in a very different way. So as you can see here, I've got lots of Botany Pots all around me. If you're familiar with the Bonsai mod or the Bonsai Pots mod, it's very similar, but it doesn't work for trees at all, or saplings. It in fact works for crops. This is more or less your farming mod, not your tree farm. It is instead your farm for multiple things, not just foods, as you might think. So how do you start with this? It's really basic. You just need to look up Botany Pots and you make a Botany Pot, which it's just a bunch of terracotta around a flower pot. Now, if you're playing in a mod pack, this may change, of course, depending upon the mod pack that you're playing in. They may change things because this is highly configurable and has a lot of different potential that you might be able to add into your own mod pack. Now, if you look here, I currently have one sitting down here, regular Botany Pot. In order to make this work, you need to place down some sort of dirt. And yes, you can use grass, you can use regular dirt, you can use all sorts of stuff here. Put that down there. I'm in creative right now, so I'm not using the blocks up. But you then click and you place down a seed of whatever crop it is you want. Now, because this counts as a dirt type, it will grow on it. Normally, you wouldn't be able to grow wheat seeds on grass in vanilla Minecraft. But as it's a dirt type, you can grow it there. You can also grow it on mycelium and a few other things like that, as long as it's in a botany pot. Now, if you see here, I'm like right-clicking, and I'm harvesting these things, and sometimes I get a drop, sometimes I don't. That's because these are regular botany pots. Once they get to full size, they will stop growing. And you can right click to harvest, and it will automatically replant anything that's there. And if there's any excess, it will pop off into the world like you just saw. And as you can see, we've got coarse dirt, we've got mycelium, we've got podzol, we've got sand, and we've got more mycelium over here. You can even harvest mushrooms. There you go, they're extra small. But if you notice, these two I clicked very close together, but yet they're growing at two different rates. It's because currently, by default, these are set up to grow at very different speeds depending upon the soils that you currently have set up. I'd recommend that you try and stick with like a podzol or a grass or even a farmed land if you can, which is very difficult to come by. But still, you can do those, and those will give you the best speed rates. After that, you just go with regular dirt. But of course, certain things will only grow on certain stuff. If you're going through regular crops, they'll grow on any of the dirt types. But if you look here, we've got a cactus, which of course will only grow on the different sand types. The mushrooms will only grow on mycelium. You've got your netherwart will only grow on soul sand. You've got your chorus fruit will only grow on endstone, and so on. And of course, there's more than just the foods that you can grow as well. You can grow the different flowers, or at least some of the different things. We've got, like in here, what kind was this one? This was the cornflower. You've got the sunflower, and so on. You've got the pink tulip. You always have to have a pink tulip. You can even grow ferns if you so want to. You just need to be able to pick it up and plant it first. And these will grow on any of the soil types as well. You can also plant these. And the best thing about these is that, look, you see that there's currently a cactus here, right? It doesn't hurt. Even if I'm in survival mode, I don't take any damage from this type of stuff. I've got some full-grown ones out here, and they don't hurt you. So therefore, it's a safer way to plant in this case, assuming that somebody hasn't, you know, messed with the configs enough to make it really bad. So these aren't going to hurt you either when you're, you know, kind of walking through them anymore. As you can see here, we've got like a rose bush, and I've got like some of the farmland on there. Got grass, even have potatoes and stuff. Now, if you upgrade these, let's grab one of these bonsai pots here. Use it with a hopper. In a crafting grid, you can make a hopping bonsai, or a hopper botany pot. Sorry, it's very similar. Hopper botany pot. What it does, let me grab one of these here, and I will plant down one by default. And you can see it actually will still grow even though there's, you know, it doesn't need two blocks above it like your other similar mods might. This one only needs one block. But if you notice, it now has this little hopper opening at the top, and that is pretty much going to represent that it's a hopper bonsai pot. And this will automatically, when it gets to full size, there you go, it just popped and is regrowing again, and it will dump any of its stuff down below into an inventory that might be, you know, underneath it, which is pretty darn cool. If you look here, I even have some barrels, are collecting carrots off on the side here, which is really cool. You've got your regular chest, you've got a furnace, you just need to add some coal or some burnable material, and it will start, you know, turning your stuff into green dye for you, etc., automatically. It's pretty darn cool. There isn't much more to it at this point. I mean, as you can see here, there are lots of different colors to choose from, but you do have to craft them from the colored terracotta. You don't just get to click on it and make change the color quite that easily. You will have to actually craft it in the color you want. But it is really nice, and it allows you a certain measure of immersiveness, so that if you don't want an entirely out of place, like this little growing area out in the desert, which doesn't seem to look right. You know, you can get something that looks a little bit more manually taken care of for something like this. And of course, you can always plant them next to each other. And you don't have to have water sources next to these. It won't really do anything to increase or decrease the speed by default. So that's about it. If you enjoyed this bit by bit and you want to see more, please be sure to give a like, comment, subscribe, and don't forget to spread the mischief to others, because that's, you know, going to help me out. And I appreciate it. Also, feel free to stop by on Twitch most nights. And we'll see you guys next time.